Jinder, and of course, my dear colleagues. I welcome you all to this faculty development program on social commitments and contributions to the society, which is indeed the need of the hour. And it's better that I come straight away to the point and keeping the past events which have happened in the past 2 or 3 days, it reminds us once again more than ever that nobody is to be blamed for anything. It's not the government, it's not the society, it's an individual. What I can do best and what values that we can inculcate in our family and in our children, to each one his own. So I'm at this point of time, I think it's absolutely relevant that ma'am is going to speak about social commitments and contributions to the society. Ma'am, to just give you a brief snapshot of the society, ma'am, Rukmini Devi Group works under the umbrella of SPMES, that is State Pokharmal Educational Society, and we have a group of institutions under us, right from Rukmini Devi Balvatika to Public School to Engineering College and of Allied Sciences. Then we have a Center for Nanotechnology, and of course this college which caters to MBA, MCA and BBA. Ma'am, apart from this, I would like to tell you that we are also NAC accredited, which is National Assessment and Accreditation Council. We've been awarded A grade, and this A grade has been awarded on the basis of the curriculum, on the teacher taught ratio, the academics, and of course the contribution of the faculty and the students that we have over here. Now, to keep it fast track, ladies and gentlemen, let me introduce you to our guest of honor, Dr. Mrs. Shobha Vijender, and let me tell you something about her. Madam is working as founder president of Sampurna NGO since September 1993, which is a very long time. Madam conducts regular welfare programs every day from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. in the northwest region of Delhi, with special emphasis on adolescent girls and women. She also runs counseling centers to develop behavioral and cognitive skills among needy clients. More than 2,000 people attend these counseling programs per annum. These centers provide the clients various alternatives to come out of the crisis situation. She also runs vocational training centers for girls and women of the age group of 15 years and above. Madam is equally involved in organizing awareness campaigns on various subjects regularly, which includes population control, consumer awareness, health and education projects. She is also equally involved in providing opportunities of elementary education, various training programs for trainers, social educators and social workers. She also runs an intervention center where abused children and victims of rape females are given counseling and other supportive services. Madam is also responsible for senior citizens integrated welfare program, including recreation center, dispensary and library. Apart from this, Madam has worked as a counselor in the family life counseling sector and drug de-addiction center in Association of Social Health in India. These are the various she has also been bench of magistrate under Juvenile Justice Act 2000 in Child Welfare Committee. She has a number of credits to her name, but apart from this, if I talk about educational qualifications, she is NET qualified, an MPhil from Social School of Social Work, a PhD from Agra University, an MA, MSW from Jamia Millia Islamia, and a BA Honours in Economics from Delhi University, which means that Madam is not just very good in academia, but she is, in fact, after looking at your resume, ma'am, there's only one thing which comes to my mind, that if you stand for something, there's very little that you'll fall down for. And you can find time for everything if you're really interested in it and you want to do it. I am so very honored that you are here, madam, and you have spared time. I would request Ms. Kanika to please felicitate madam. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, sir. Thank you, Kanika. Ladies and gentlemen, also at this point of time, I think, madam, I would like to tell you a little about Director General, sir. I will not go into his educational qualifications, but let me tell you that these educational qualifications from IIT Delhi and IIT Bombay stand very short in front of what he actually does. Probably he mentors a lot of us, he disciplines a lot of us, but at the end of the day, I think if something has to be done, it needs a lot of disciplining and mentoring. Only then you can actually go on with whatever you meant to do. So that is Colonel Mahendra Singh. At this point of time, I would request Ms. Neetu Goyal, ma'am, to please come on stage and to please give the memento and to felicitate madam. this point of time, I would request Madam to please take stage and, of course, to tell all of us what we can do, most importantly, to avoid everything that we are facing these days.
Namaskar, everybody. First of all, I would like to apologize for being late because you must have seen a big tent outside, just opposite to your institute. And we all know what is happening in our country. And as you were telling about my academic qualifications and then about sir, what I have seen in during last 25 years after completing my master's in social work, then there is an urgent need, not of educational qualification, but really to do something in the practical life. We have degrees, we have educational backgrounds, but still we are not able to do anything justified with the people. Ultimately, whatsoever we are doing, you people are doing something wonderful in computer skills or computer education, in technology. But for whom we are doing this? Ultimately for the human beings. And if the net result is not up to the mark, it is the time that we all have to ponder upon, we all have to introspect. Friends, you are the faculty members and I know you better understand what is the present situation. And Colonel Sahab and Mr. Garg must have invited me thinking that now social work, real social work or corporate social work. Nowadays we are talking a lot of about corporate social work, but the social work which is coming from inside, it is not something from the outside that we have to, you know, learn it from something else. It is from inner side. But now the time has come that we have to just look into this, that where it is. We are so busy in our day-to-day activities that in 24 hours we don't have time to think upon what we are doing, and life goes on. And when life passes on after 60 or 65, then we repent that we have done nothing. But the institutions, the educational institutes are doing a lot of work in this direction, and I'm very happy that Rukmani Devi Institute is also taking pioneer efforts in this. As I think that why this topic has been chosen for today, because of the reason there is a need of it, and we should do what is the need of the time. Why we are talking of this capital punishment for today? Because when CRPC was written, when criminal law was made, capital punishment was not required. And we never believe that the crimes of such intensity or violence-based crime or crime against women will increase. I would like to share one very important fact that after independence, our whole development programs, welfare programs based on one point, when women are educated, then development will go on and things will improve. But my dear friends, after 60 or 65 years of independence, we have seen that this development model in India is not working. I can give you ample of examples for that. But one very shocking example which I would like to share with you is this, that female feticide, which we are talking about every day, and which is the most important problem of today's time, because you will get the result after 15 or 20 years. According to one research, the female feticide rate is very high in South Delhi as compared to the walled city. And let me tell you, in South Delhi, there is a huge, huge percentage of women where they are graduates and postgraduates. And in walled city, there is a high percentage where the girls are not even 10th passed. See the situation. So when education will increase, female feticide will go up or down? Just you think. When female employment will increase, what will happen? We have never planned. We have given education, we have given employment, we have done so many things for females, but the mindset of the 50% of the population, that is male, we have not done anything for that. And I think this is the crux of my lecture, but I don't know, I am so provoked today that I am coming, you know, the ultimate was I am talking in the beginning, because I cannot bear this with this. But now see, the things are worsening with so much frequently that social researchers are not able to cope up with the situation. In developing countries, where we are talking about that in Indian situation, still rate of crime is not so high as compared to the most Western countries and American countries. Let me give you another example. According to one research, in 2020, in Delhi, 10% of the population is going to suffer with acute depressions. 1.25 crore is the population of Delhi presently. You can well understand, 10% is not a small number. What we have done, what we have planned for coming 8 years. In Delhi itself, still, we are not able to take care of the physical ailments. Still, a huge, huge number of women are not getting the basic health facilities in capital of India. We are not prepared that what is going to happen when 10% of the population of Delhi is going to suffer with depressions. We don't have any means to help those women or those men or those population. And when we are talking of the Western countries, when we are talking to the American countries, since I am running my counseling center in Rohini itself for the last many, many years, whenever I go to any country, I try to find out how do they deal with their social problems. And I'm surprised and happy to see in London, in every nook and corner, you will find the counseling family relationship or family counseling centers. And the system is so perfect. Obviously, problems are there. But the system to deal with those problems for redressal is so good, is so advanced, that if they have any problem, they can deal with the situation. But in our country, we are running CIC, Crisis Intervention Center. I am running Family Counseling Center. Let me tell you very clearly, who are coming to my center? Always misguided. Any woman who is coming to me, suffering, disturbed, with some social or family problem, she has something in mind that I am going to an NGO, or what the NGO will do. They will do something for the mother-in-law, against the husband, or against something. I mean, they are not coming there to solve their problem. They are coming that something drastic, something unjustified will be done with their male counterparts or with the family. They are misguided. So in our society, still we are not prepared with the third party. family system has broken. Now we are all living in the nuclear families. If there is husband-wife dispute, if there is problem with the children, if there is problem within the siblings, nobody is coming down from the family. Then who is the party? Party is the NGO. But there is everywhere a confusion. Everywhere something wrong is spread out. That you will go to the NGO, ladies will be there, they will favor the ladies, they will do this, this and this. And from that point of view, from that angle, if NGO really wants to help the woman, she is not able to do. This is one. And when we really want to help the woman is really a sufferer. She wants some solutions from our side. I will give you one example that will help you that to make you understand the situation. 2 years ago, a woman came to us and there was blood all over her face. And she said, my husband has beaten me through a cricket bat. And she was crying and crying. And obviously, first of all, our counselor went with her to the doctor, to the hospital, and medical facilities were given to her. And when she was able to say something, it was 10:30 or so in December. She came back at 4 o'clock because we cannot give her, we don't have any means that we can, that a lady can go to the any private doctor. She was taken to the government hospital, and there is a protocol according to, for an NGO, they have to go for any problem, solution of any problem, for medical problem, to the government hospital. So it took 4 to 5 hours. When she came back and she said, madam, now I will, she told me the story that from the very beginning, from the day one, she was not even beaten by the husband, by everyone in the family. And they, the father-in-law is in police, and husband, runs big buses and all. And financially, they are well off. They don't have any problem. And she is coming from a very nearby village. I won't tell you the name. And she said, without any reason, it is their habit. Whenever she comes, suppose she is going outside from the kitchen, mother-in-law will do this. I mean, she will give dhakka. Yeah, matlab, if she passes by, wo dhakka aise, aise usko kar degi. Without any reason, without any provocation, without anything. And now the things have deteriorated with the reason that they don't allow this lady to talk or to do something for the children. She had 2 children also. So I was there only, and I said, okay, we will take care of the problem. But she was so frightened, she was so fearful. She said, no, I will not go to home back. I mean, if I have come out from my home, they won't allow me to go to the, to come back again. I thought she is saying like this. She is, today she is worried, she is frightened. So she is saying, she is too fearful today. So I, for that particular night, I sent her to Connaught Place, one of the women's shelter. She remained there. And the second day, when along with the another counselor, I went there and wanted to meet her. She said, ma'am, I will meet you when, please, you allow me, I will stay back here. मैंने कहा, यू हैव 2 children ऑल्सो. कहते हैं, नो आई कान गो मैम, मुझे वो मार देंगे, मैं किसी हालत में नहीं जा सकती. लेकिन हमारा, वी वर डीलिंग विद हर देयर, बट थिंग्स विल वर वर्किंग हेयर ऑल्सो, वी वर वर्किंग हेयर ऑल्सो इन आर सेंटर. देन वन ऑफ आवर काउंसलर ट्राई टू कॉन्टैक्ट द हस्बैंड एंड द फादर इन लॉ एंड एवरीबडी इन द फैमिली दैट योर डॉटर इन लॉ सेड दिस थिंग एंड यू हैव टू प्लीज कम आउट एंड मीट द लेडी. They started abusing all our counselor. They said all nonsense thing to us. And they said once she has left, जैसे कोई राम की, कोई उसने बड़ी लक्ष्मण रेखा, उसने कोई क्रॉस कर दी हो, तो अब वो किसी हालत में हमारे घर में नहीं आ सकती. उसने पूरे हमारे गाँव का अपमान किया है. I felt very bad. And unfortunately, when I tried to contact the mother side of that girl, they even responded so adversely that I can't tell you. Thus, they said, why she came to you? शी शुड स्टे बैक देयर, हमने शादी कर दी, हमने ये. मैंने कहा यू आर, व्हाट आर यू टॉकिंग, वी आर डीलिंग विद अ प्रॉब्लम इन दिल्ली, द गर्ल इज फ्रॉम दिल्ली, ये बहुत पास में ही है आपके बादली साइड में, इट्स नॉट वेरी फार ऑफ, क्या बात कर रहे हैं आप लोग. एंड वी ट्राइड अवर बेस्ट एंड आफ्टर टू ईयर्स द गर्ल इज इन शेल्टर होम. And Delhi Commission, then we gave the case to the Delhi Commission for Women. Because of the reason, we were not able to deal with the case. Nobody cooperating, neither the this side or this side. Now the girl is learning this beautician course. But she is in acute depression. She is not happy. I mean, ultimately, because you are the faculty members, ultimately, whenever I think about this particular case, I think what we have done, whether we have justified with the girl, what we have done. Because she, what, for what we have done this, all this, to give her support, to make her happy. But frankly speaking, she is not happy. She is not happy. She is doing everything there. She has started learning and she is planning to open a beauty parlor also, this and that. We will also help her. But ultimately, something for what we have done this, that is her happiness, to make her happy, that is not there. So what I mean to say is that our society is not fertile enough to see that women are going outside, that women are educated, that women are learning something, that women are self-dependent, that women can take decisions. I'm surprised to see there is a woman, doctor woman, and she is not able to take small decision of her home, like to which school her son will go for study. She cannot take this decision. She is so helpless. She even cannot buy a sari. I mean, I was surprised to see she is a doctor. She earns so much and there is a galla, you know, in her room. And whatever she earns from morning 9 to 2, she puts everything, money there in that galla. And in the evening, her husband comes. He is also a doctor. And he counts everything. And whenever the lady doctor needs anything, she has to ask the husband that give me 2,000 or 4,000 or so. This is the situation. So ultimately, what I want to say is this. I don't want to provoke everybody, but I want to tell you the real situation. So where is the solution? I think solution lies at the micro level, within us only. Social policies, government policies can do wonders. That's true. But here the problem lies within us. The day a mother starts treating the male child and the female child alike, equal, things will definitely improve. Those rapists who have done this barbaric act with the girl must have been given some sanskar, some values by the mother, by the family itself. Sometimes we used to say that why all the time you are blaming or you are saying about the mothers, but why not about the father? That's also true. A family unit completes with father and mother both. If mother is completely sanskari, but father is not that. I have hundreds of examples that child learns good values. But in those cases where a female does not take care as she should take, or her attitude or behavior or the way she takes the things is not up to the mark, and husband is 100% fine, things will not work in the right direction. So ultimately, in the family unit, husband and wife role is very, very important, equally important. But the values, the sanskar, or this system of inculcation of values only comes through the women. Yesterday, I was reading a small speaking tree in the Bharat Times by Osho. He said yes. And Osho ko kabhi bhi padho to there is always a confusion also, conflicting also, this and that. But sometimes he talks, And he said something very nice. He said, from women, what we want? Definitely we want skills, education, this and that. But the love, the music, the compassion, the kindness, these things are coming from the women only. During my study with the drug addicts and criminals, I went to Tihar jail for a year to meet the hardcore criminals for my study. And Singh Sahib, you will be surprised to know the hardened criminals. When I interview to them, when I talk to them, I found them so innocent. They wait me for 2 hours, for 3 hours, and they talk, you know, childlike things. What do they want from others? Actually, the world ultimately is suffering because of love. Love, it's everywhere. It's in the institutions, it's in the home, it's in a school, everywhere. The kindness, the compassion, the love we used to give, we used to share to others is lacking. And ultimately, we have started looking at the fruits of this lack of love everywhere. This depression, avsa, dukh is coming from there only. So let's start from the lecture what I have planned. That today's topic, social commitment and social contributions. Since we are the social animals, as soon as we take birth, social commitment is there. Social commitment is something subjective. As soon as we start learning so many things, then we understand that we have some duty, some rights towards everybody, and we should do this and this and this. And psychologically too, in every heart there are two things. One is positive and one is negative. And it is only the environment, which includes everybody, family, school, everything, that if he has the exposure to the positive things, this positive part enhance. And if he or she has this negative exposure to the things, this negative part enhance. Sutherland's theory, social learning theory. And that is why you will always find, because I have worked with children also for 6 years as a bench of magistrate in child welfare committees. And I have seen there small children of 7 years, 6 years, those who are living on the streets, they will make you buddhu like this.